Hello everyone, GoFan77 here, and I've decided to take the opportunity and finally do a little video I've been meaning to do for a while, and that is how to play the Galactic Empire. Basically, a bit of basically me just going through a game and explaining how I envision this faction playing when I created it, what their strengths are, some of the ways that you can best optimize your playstyle with them. And as the first faction we released, and probably the most polished, it only makes sense to start with them. So, I am in a game here with myself as the Galactic Empire, and one lore-friendly human traitor state ally. And we are playing against the coalition of the Rebel Alliance and the Vasari. So, this is just a medium map, so it won't hopefully drag on too long. So, time to start with build order, I suppose. My first start with the Empire is almost always the same. You only have, your strap battle ships are very powerful, but because they're so high tier, you only have two to start out with, the two victory classes. And quite simply, I always get the Victory 1 to use as a colony ship. And I also always get exactly two Carracks and a Sentinel landing ship aft. I hold off on any buildings until I see my immediate surroundings. Planet. If I have at least two planets, like asteroids or moons or whatever, I will go a military lab. If it looks like I need, I'm going to have to go through planets that require colonization research immediately, I'll drop a civic lab.
Scouts have found a colonizable planet.
And I have my asteroid and moon. Awesome. So I'm going to throw down Naval Research Station.
Sentinel awaiting orders.
That is basically my starting build.
Comlink active. Right away.
First thing I do is immediately send my two Carracks over Gunship to the most reporting. Isolated planet for them to take. This reason
reporting
is that
in.
Two Carracks are sufficient to clear the single modified Corvette and Nebulon B2 frigate that will be guarding moons or the dwarf planets now, my apologies, and asteroids.
Moving into position. Yes, Commander. Receiving location.
The Sentinel landing craft I'll have follow them once they clear it out and colonize it. The Empire's colony frigate is sort of unique in that it is a very cheap colony frigate,
preparing,
but it is the only one that is
jump.
Consumed on use. So, that is partly why I recommend everyone get the Victory class, so you have a capital ship that is capable of
phase jump complete
colonizing it, so you don't have to constantly build
weapons
sentinels
ready
to keep up
launching
with you.
Attack.
And for catching, like, this is actually a really perfect scenario
structure
to use
complete.
The Sentinel, since it's just one planet off my normal path. You really just
Sentinel
want something cheap
orders.
As you get the job done.
Our fleet
so.
Is under attack!
Oh,
found
I probably should have put TIE
Fighters.
Oh, okay, I did build TIE Fighters. Of course, we're gonna get established garrison as the ability, so I can colonize this hunk of rock. Looks like me and my ally spawned on opposite sides, so that's a little unfortunate. And I might just build an extra two scouts since I don't think our
There's
scouts
work to
be will
done.
Be.
Are you interested?
Catching up, you probably want me to send an envoy. Yes, you do. I don't know if I'll be able to do that in half an hour. Okay, research lab
Tossing
is done.
Crews are reporting.
I'm gonna grab skip ray blast
scouts boats. Have found a colonized
Corvettes
planet.
Of all factions. In this case, the Empire's skip ray are very useful for expanding early on because they are very good against siege frigates. In this case, the Nebulon B2 is your neutral siege frigate, so taking them out as fast as
Weapons
possible.
Weapons ready!
In this case, you can see here, my victory class has destroyed the Nebulon B2 here. That modified Corvette cannot damage the colony once I establish it, so I can
planet.
Get it out right away. It is quite nice compared to a lot of the other factions that the Empire has such an easy, at least simple way to clear dwarf planets. If I'm playing as the Rebels, I send the equivalent number of running corvettes, but without my micromanaging them, I tend to lose one.
Scouts have
in the
found
battle.
A colonizable planet.
The Empire's frigates are tend to be very much sort of a Protoss
reporting
style play.
In.
They're very
navigating to coordinates.
Expensive, but also very strong, so you tend to have smaller numbers of better ships with them.
Allied forces are being
and
attacked.
And that Navion B2 is almost gone. That volcanic
at once,
is
sir.
Actually pretty weakly defended, but I really can't pass up grabbing another asteroid right here. Oh, and I didn't even get my colonization research. Throw down administration center so I can get volcanic colonization as soon as I'm able to get over there.
Yes,
oh, yeah.
Commander.
Send the Sentinel.
Arrival imminent.
Dwarf planet. I'm also gonna grab some the probe droid research I also rather like, and I'll build some skip rays to help my Star Destroyer.
Frequency open.
Clear out any planets faster. Thought I built some. Don't hide down there.
Tartan cruiser reporting.
Ready for orders, sir.
Oh, where do I want you to go? Ooh, urban planet. Oh, the plague. Well, that's
skip ray blast
ooh,
boat here.
Forge.
Our fleet
well,
is under attack.
Fun later. Kind of wish I knew what this was. I'm not sure. I'll just send you there in case.
Research
there you
complete.
Go. My skip rays are gone.
Advance.
You can go hang out with the victory. Alright, no, I do not quite have my civic research center done. Might as well get some turbo laser damage just while I'm waiting for things. Sentinel is about to colonize that. Let's see. Oh, some unique things about the Empire's start. You do start with the planetary shield generator, which will give you that 65% planet bombing absorption. So you're fairly a bit more resistant to rushes since that would normally would normally take you 5 military labs to build, so that's rather nice on small
Allied
maps and just to have in general.
Attacked.
Also, all races have their own special planet bonuses on their homeworld to help
complete.
Differentiate. You know, otherwise, homeworlds don't usually start with planet bonuses, or they're
structure complete.
Basically just plain planets. So I kind of was tired of constantly conquering my enemy's capital, and oh, it's another generic, boring, Terran planet. So I decided to give them all race-specific bonuses. The Imperial Homeworld's
scouts
huge
have found a colonizable planet.
Factor is that it starts with a 5% shipbuild discount, so that is a fairly rare bonus. It's not that much, but it means that you have a very... You have, at the start of the game, you're going to have the best shipbuilding capacity off your homeworld until you can find industrial planet has a guaranteed 10%, and then other planet types, if you explore, you might find ones that give a better discount, but being guaranteed to have one planet in your empire with a ship build discount is rather nice.
Cruiser reporting.
Have that asteroid, are you calling it? That is a colonizable gas giant. Unfortunately, I guess I could.
Coming about.
Alright, sure. Actually, I'll upgrade my logistics capacity. Throw down an administration center on my homeworld.
Ready for orders, sir.
I'll go take the gas giant.
On the double.
Okay, we found a rebel planet over there. So I'm gonna want to, oh. Contaminated planet. Interesting.
Our fleet is under attack!
There's a lot of special planets in my section of space. That's hardly a bad thing.
Allied
I'm gonna go for my upgrade my Terran planet population. As Galactic Empire, you are very good at taxes, and you like your really high population planets, like Terrans, Urbans. Thank goodness I got one, although looks like it's going to be very slow to develop because of that plague on there.
Scouts have found a colonizable planet.
But especially planet industrial, urban, and Terran are going to be your ideal planet types. And then you basically Just want to tax the shit out of them.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Phase jump complete.
And they're all chasing something.
Scouts have found a colonizable planet.
Yeah, I should probably develop that asteroid. Would be a good idea. And there's the Rebel homeworld. But it looks like they only have two planets. Thanks to my double colonization strategy, I have four. So kind of merge my fleets now together, so it's not quite as effective as it could have been, but meh. I didn't want to wait in. I guess I could rank up now.
Structure complete.
Another unique feature of the Empire is that their fleet and capital ship research are combined into this rank system. Basically, you start out as, I don't know, an ensign, and you
structure complete.
Go up to lieutenant, captain, or commander, captain, all the way up to grand admiral, each giving you more ship slots. It's also how you get most of your higher tier star destroyers, so if you want to get outside of just building a victory class, you're going to want to put some points into that. I think I will go ahead and do that. Alright. I can get hazard garrisons. Do that first. This will let me
get found a colonizable planet.
Colonizable gas giants, contaminated planets, and greenhouse. Huh, all three happen to be on this map. In fact, there's a few greenhouse planets on this
Allied
map.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Anyway. Looks like we are mopping up the
gunship
neutral
reporting.
Forces here. Colonizable gas giants are kind of interesting. They're expensive to develop, but they are guaranteed to have a positive, valuable atmosphere bonus, which gives some extra trade income. So once you develop it, they can be quite profitable.
Research
they are very
complete.
Fragile, though, since there's obviously no terrain on the
Research
planet.
Complete.
All your population is in floating cities, like Bespin. In fact, that was the whole inspiration for this planet type. And so, yeah. Fragile, but quite profitable if you're willing to sink some money in them. Then
navigating
them.
To coordinates.
And I can colonize it now.
Armed and ready.
Can I take you? I really want to colonize that urban planet. I can get some more skip rays over here. Pretty easily. I'm also going to grab. My
a
first
new
skill
colony
unit
has
is
been
not
founded.
Quite in range yet, so I'm going to grab Warship Reactivation, which will allow me to get the Venator Star Destroyer, which is the Empire's carrier capital ship, and probably the second most recognizable ship you have, thanks
Research
to the
complete.
Clone Wars. So, they're quite worthwhile, I'd say.
Skipway Blast Boat here. Weapons online.
Actually, I'm gonna grab this contaminated planet. Contaminated planets have the highest crystal income of any planet in the game. Not very much in tax income. I think it's a max of 50. They tend to have. Well, this one doesn't have any negative traits, so that's good. That'll help me research and be in game quite nicely, I think. I could sell some spare metal. We got a Venator.
Comlink active. On the double.
I'm gonna send the ships I just built over there. Build a few more
additional credits
skip
required.
Rays, I guess, to help my Venator. I'm gonna build, clear out this
structure
organic
complete.
Planet.
Skipway Blast Boat here.
I'm basically going to have my
Sentinel awaiting orders.
Second fleet for now and try and get this volcanic and swamp planet, since it looks like the front line of the rebels. We're going to be in this between this inhospitable planet on that oceanic planet. Still not quite making money on that.
Awaiting your orders.
But we're getting some mines up. That's always nice.
Awaiting your orders.
And I have a Venator. Yay.
Your orders.
One of each. TIE fighters and TIE bombers, and I always get the SPHAT beam, strat beam, however you want to pronounce it.
Our fleet is under attack.
It is a very powerful single target attack that does basically double damage if during the duration of the attack you breach the target's shields. So, very
weapons
powerful,
online.
Especially
advance.
If Com you can bring the target shield down.
Phase jump complete.
Shields down.
Gunship reporting.
Which means it pops these militia frigates quite easily. The Azeri cartel, which is our representation of like the entire Star Wars underworld.
Structure complete.
Black Sun, Talon Karad's organization, what's left of the Hutts, they're all basically
planet development finished.
Little collection.
Reporting in.
And they're the ones you'll mainly be fighting in the first part of the game. Ally could be going a little faster. Looks like they just got their fourth planet. Oh yeah, see? I already up to four tax income as I'm developing the planet here. Go on more. Oh, I should grab, prefabricated garrisons is a nice tech that lets you build up population upgrades very quickly and somewhat more cheaply. And since I have a colonizable gas giant planet, that's definitely going to be used.
Yes, Commander.
How much else did I give it? Yeah, I have 1,050 health, so that's 450 less than
allied
your average
are
planet.
Being attacked.
So, yeah. The Vasari want to come over there and take it from me, they could do so
structure complete.
Quite quickly. We'll probably put up some defense platforms over there later, but I don't want to ruin my start to by building defense
research
platforms
complete.
Too quickly. The Empire has sort of a combined turret and hangar defense, the Golan III defense platform, and they're very effective, especially when upgraded, very
founded.
Efficient, but they use 6 tactical slots, and they are quite expensive. But, hey, they can stand up moderately well to a Star Destroyer with support, so...
Awaiting instructions.
You get what you pay for. Especially when you have time to do some of the research here in the Preservation Tree to give them extra fighters and missile launchers. Another thing about grabbing 3 civic labs as the Empire early is very useful because
research
you get
complete.
Culture, refinery, and trades all with
planet
3 labs.
Development
so that's
finished.
All of your main civic buildings as well as all your colonization
Skipper reporting.
Are going to be on.
Comlink active. Let's move out. Order acknowledged. Order acknowledged.
Of course, I've been neglecting my military, but quite honestly, you can expand quite well with just light frigates and corvettes. That's not a huge issue. I guess I'll start getting my HP up, which would be useful later on since it's also a requirement to get dreadnoughts. Sort of a mixture between a support cruiser and a heavy cruiser. Very durable.
Sentinel awaiting orders.
Can heal your ships outside of combat, but.
Additional research required.
Oh, crap. I didn't even do volcanic. All right. Thermal garrisons, please. I want that volcanic.
Skipper reporting.
All right. I'm about to get
awaiting your commands.
Also, notice I have line of sight. Oh, that's... Why can't I see, though? That's my allies there. Why can't I see
research
this?
Research complete.
I really don't know. Expecting that,
allied
okay.
Forces are being attacked.
See, I have a probe droid at this planet, because I have a remote sensor there, so... My scouts
development
are
finished.
Actually, at least one of them still alive and holding in there, so that's nice.
Structure complete.
Destination is acknowledged.
Oh... I'm gonna put a rally point on my second fleet here.
Research complete.
Also notice I'm not actually using the fleet feature. I suppose there's arguments
gunship
you could go
reporting.
Either way about whether it's useful
coming
or
about.
Not, but
ready to commence.
I don't like it because your ships like to organize themselves into formations in the middle of combat.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
so I tend just to use,
Your orders. Executing orders.
Another good thing about going for action. Nebula on B2s first is that they can launch Z95 headhunters like we just saw there. Which will harass you in a single one, not a squad, but still.
Yes, Commander.
Awaiting instructions.
Send reinforcements there, and we are also fighting ready for the action. Urban planet here, which does have a dreadnought defending it, so it'll be a little tougher. Also, the Marauder cruisers can be a little nasty, especially if you have a lot of light frigates.
Reporting in.
3 victory now, so it's slowly going up there. While we wait on the combat, what's some of the things to talk about? Oh yeah, the every faction in this
structure
mod and every
complete.
Race has their own set of inherent bonuses that are active at the start of the game without research. You'll notice these showed up as research, even though I never clicked them. So you get things like as the Empire, extra population on Terran
Allied
planets, extra tax
attacked.
Income. You actually get income from your capital ships, you get a little bit of tax income, and turbo laser increase, tactical slot increase. Then as my specific fashion, the Galactic Empire as opposed to the Warlords, which is a different Imperial faction. I get extra armor in my own gravity wells, extra shipbuild increase, get a little bit better use on bounty, and I kill more people in bombing. Terrible, but
I await your instructions.
Empire. I am evil. I don't care how many civilians get in the way of.
At your command.
Security and order. And we just took down the shields off that dreadnought, so that's coming out nicely. Not really bombing anything now. In fact, I didn't even
Pirate
get any
raiders are on the loose.
Neutral fractions in my way. I did just get pirates sent at me, and quite simply, there's a reason I just let it hit me, and that is the pirates are actually a lot easier to deal with if you just don't put bounty up. Yeah, you have a chance of sending them at your enemies, but if it gets sent at you, if you're not, if there's no bounty in the black market, you're guaranteed to get a low pirate raid, basically. In this mod, the pirates mainly care about how much money you've thrown at them.
And we're on our way.
Now the dreadnought blew up. Yay. Oh, I probably should have bought another sentinel. That's alright. We're still fighting.
Sentinel awaiting orders.
And my Venator leveled up. I'm gonna get expanded hangar base. What do I take next? That is
inhospitable.
No dreadnought, so I'm going with another TIE fighter. The TIE bombers are mainly quite nice to help deal with those dreadnoughts guarding high value worlds. So I have this urban planet. Unfortunately, it has 50% slower population growth from the virulent plague here. Doesn't reduce the population, strangely enough, but it's going to take a while for it to go up to its heights. Urban planets do have the highest
Weapons
population
ready.
Of any planet in the game, save the special planet Coruscant, so naturally. Oh, hey. I guess my ally just sent me an envoy through the pirate base. That's interesting. I suppose I could do the same. Labda Shuttle, of course, is your envoy frigate, and you can use them to build embassies at your ally. Help boost them up a bit, get them to like you more. Good stuff.
Planet development finished.
Ready for battle.
Oh, let's see. Now I kind of have a hard time expanding this way because there is a neutral Visari, not my enemy Visari over here, confusingly enough, but the Visari Remnants is a minor faction, and they are guarding this ice planet, though it's a death world, so it's not that great of a planet anyways. And there's a pair of dreadnoughts going there.
TIE is reporting in.
Planet, but
at your command.
Research complete.
Come back to this gas giant. Just
sentinel standing by.
Be around.
Your orders.
All right.
Executing orders.
There's a Corvette. If they expanded this way already, that's a little unfortunate. I was hoping to get that inhospitable planet, but oh well.
Your orders?
And I'm level 3. Better SWAT beam. And 2 and 2 now, planet level 3. So finished. 4 squadrons for a level 3 capital ship is pretty nice, honestly. Thanks to that expanded Hanniger Bay ability.
Allied forces are
passive,
being attacked.
I should say. And I need to up to my military, I think. After all, you did not just sit here and come to watch this to see me just use Carrix and skip Ray Blastpulse Oday. No, even
preparing
how
for hyperspace jump.
And underrated. Oh, there's the pirates. I forgot about
that. Gunship reporting. We're on our way.
Another nice thing about the early pirates, they don't have siege frigates, so I honestly have no reason to worry about losing the planet. They might blow up my research center, that will be inconvenient.
Awaiting your orders.
Really, not the end of the world.
Order acknowledged.
Alright, send
Lander reporting.
Don't follow the vendor.
Receiving location.
Colonize that, please.
Phase jump complete.
Should upgrade the emergency facilities there.
A new colony has been founded.
And I have Swamp Planet. Hooray.
Planet development finished. Our ally's planet is under siege.
I guess I'll build a lambda for my ally. How much time? I don't know if I can get there in 7 minutes, but we'll try.
Structure complete.
Well, the rebels looks like they've cleared out this planet, but they didn't actually colonize it, so that's nice. We'll see if I can nab it and fortify it before
Sentinel
they
awaiting
send
orders.
A real force this way.
Lambda shuttle ready.
Planet development finished.
Sentinel standing by. Arrival imminent. Receiving location.
Our backup is joining the fight.
Sin's pathfinding. Don't you love how they love to go through neutral planets? Well, the rebels are clearing out the militia quite quickly there. Also with light frigates, the Corellian Corvette, and
structure
the
complete.
Corvette, the X-4 gunship.
Research complete.
Skip Ray reporting. Ready to commence.
Sentinel, or my Lambda shuttle is online.
Cleared for departure.
Oh, how do I want to send them there?
Skip Ray blast boat here.
Take the safer,
course approved.
Longer route.
Our backup is joining the
on
fight.
On this side, we only have this uncolonizable. Oh, go figure. Bespin is the uncolonizable Jess giant.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
That's just a little generic. A few units didn't have hyperspace
planet development
voiceovers, so you might hear that from time to time.
Our planet
oh, we got a few more
siege.
Ships coming in. No capitals.
Ready for action.
So better get
advanced.
Some reinforcements over there.
Armed and ready.
Some skip rays are starting to harass the pirates.
Research complete.
Starting nice. Attack position.
Main fleet is about to jump in. Also nice. Oh,
structure
better
complete.
Start getting some culture and trade up. So I can finance
preparing
my
for hyperspace jump.
End game here. Scout. Nah.
Your orders.
A few more here.
Our backup is joining the fight.
Not anything they can really use against my TIE fighters, though. Corvettes can fire on them a little bit, but
orbital command available.
Research complete.
I'm actually gonna get All right, cool. I can build some dreadnoughts. I see a lot of people really like these things because, you know, like Let's Plays I've watched of other people because they're so tough, and that's true, and you can also get them earlier because
research
they
complete.
Need two military labs and two civic labs, the same warship reactivation tech that you get over here to get the Venator is needed
complete.
For the Dreadnought, but they do much weaker damage than some of your other, per fleet supply than some of your other units. They can heal, and they do have a come with a small TIE fighter squadron, so, I mean, definitely worth having a few around, but especially in this early stage of the game, where light frigates and corvettes
Research
that
complete.
The rebels are throwing at me here. Oh, they have two Corellian gunships. Uh-oh. Now they can shoot down my fighters, eventually. So I'm probably going to send my main fleet to reinforce them. So I'm going to set a rally point.
Research complete.
Sentinel awaiting orders.
Sentinel's not
quite
there.
I await your
there.
Instructions.
If I can colonize it and get a golem platform off, we should be alright. I start building repair base
Allied
here.
Allied forces are being attacked.
On my front line with the Vasari, just in case they make it around the desert and
frigate standing by for
fortified
orders.
Fortified ice planet. I kind of doubt that they'll do that anytime soon, but just in case. And we're mopping up the pirate attack, and as you can see, I didn't even lose my research lab. They took out two
Our
of my mines,
is joining the fight.
But I mean,
ready to commence.
50 credits each, so not a huge loss by any means. How's
Your
the
orders.
Predator going? Shields have been better. They're still there.
Skipway blast boat here.
And we got some reinforcements coming in, so that's nice. Oh, I never developed a volcanic. Ugh. Something about doing commentary while playing Sims makes you make all sorts of basic mistakes you never do if you're actually playing. As some of you may know if you've seen some of the multiplayer vids I've done with other modders, but. And Star Destroyer shields are down. I think we should
Gunship
be okay
reporting.
As long as they don't send in a capital Structure ship of their own
complete.
For a little bit. Alright, we'll go through the radiation cloud, see what sort of presence they have.
Structure complete.
Maybe build a tower and try and capture the metal they have there. Rebuilding stuff there.
Planet development finished.
Tartan cruiser reporting.
I'll throw down another naval research station so I can get gladiators. Probably my favorite
Structure complete.
Cruiser frigate size ship in the game.
Comlink active.
Why not build dreadnoughts? Oh, there's the dreadnoughts.
Structure complete.
Have them start building their TIE fighters to help reinforce my Venator.
Comlink active.
Mr. Sentinel.
Arrival
kinda
imminent.
I needed that colonized yesterday. Lancers would be nice to get rid of these extra gunships.
Structure
as well,
complete.
But
Structure
Tyrant
complete.
Is level 4, excellent. Another fighter squad. I think we'll go bomber now that Renounce will be giving a little bit
Allied
more TIE fighters on the side.
Planet development finished. Phase jump complete. A new colony has been founded.
And there's nothing
Moving
here.
Into position.
Terrific. Oh, yeah, that turret I built.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Is, of course, going
Full
to
speed.
The rally point, which is on the Venator. Yeah, I'm not quite going to make that mission. Dang it. Oh, well.
Structure complete.
Helping out your allies is always a good thing. I should probably research the first bonus ability imported later.
Your failure makes a poor impression.
I should let my embassies, once I build them and my ally over here, build stuff faster.
Our backup is joining the fight.
My ally is rushing the rebels, and I'm about to take out a capital ship. This might be a rather short game, actually. Interesting. Well, may as well build a culture center here. Oh. No, Virulent Plague does not hurt culture, right? So, yeah, why not? We'll throw a culture center there. Druckenwell.
Structure
yeah,
complete.
Rebels are kind of regretting coming here now.
Research complete.
And we'll throw down that Golan defense platform.
Research complete.
And I'll research my extra fighters.
Skipper reporting.
And the rebels have retreated from the advancing Imperial fleet.
Awaiting instructions.
Primitive by Imperial standards. We should be able to fix that relatively soon. Gladiators! My own bias aside, these are
Allied forces
really
are
awesome
attacked.
Ships. Fairly expensive and maybe
structure
not quite as
complete.
Good as focus firing as a lot of the vanilla ships, but they also get a small squadron of
structure
TIE fighters
complete.
And they are pretty good damage dealers. Not the best armor, but they have longer
research
range.
Complete.
They're your long-range frigate. They blow up Corellian corvettes, capital ships fairly well as long as they're farther away.
Reporting.
I see some people get a little confused with the broadside cruiser, which was, of course, the long-range ship in Empire War, but we're actually using it as the siege, or rather the anti-structure frigate, so it's only used to blow up space stations. Ooh, rebels have a carrier out.
Structure complete.
Carriers are both the rebels' way of getting strike craft, obviously, but they can also bomb planets of Y-wings, so they're their siege frigate as well, which makes them a bit dangerous.
Reporting.
Ooh, my allies about to lose their capital ship, even though they took out the rebel Dauntless. So.
Structure complete.
I think they're about to lose it. Coral battleships can be a bit of pain of an ass to kill, but.
Weapons online.
Could push my advantage and take out this oceanic world, but I think I'm gonna
structure
just get my
complete.
Interior set up. Get a trade chain going. Get my economy in shape.
Intel reports an impending.
Actually, this gas giant has a trade bonus. We'll probably do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 planet trade chain already. Looks good to me. Oops, that's not a trade port.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Put a few trade ports here, I think, actually.
Structure complete.
On the way.
Structure complete.
I copy.
And my gladiators
structure
are
structure complete.
Route.
Planet development finished.
I have my first embassy at my ally, and my Lambda shuttles, and I'm going to build them at the rest of the planets.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Star base already. It's unusual considering they're attacking already, but then that is what HTS does. They're very much a rush offensive faction. TEC Rebels, if you're more familiar with the vanilla game.
Structure complete.
May as well grab my own starbase. Ooh, I'm gonna grab.
Structure complete.
That and that.
Space
lanes is kind of nice to boost, gives you slight trade and tactical slot increase, which I really need to build more golem platforms since you use so much tactical slots. And I'm also going to try and grab the political prisoners tech here. This will let all my metal mines produce credits.
Awaiting instructions.
Empire is a very strong credit economy, although they mainly get it from things other than trade, which is a little unusual. Oh, are they attacking me again?
Research
Pirates
complete.
Are attacking me again, but they are attacking the planet where my fleet is currently.
Ready for orders, sir.
So,
research
I'll see
complete.
How well that works for them.
Structure complete.
Build some lancers just to deal with any fighters the rebels may think about building. It looks like they have fended off my allies'
a
attack for now,
arrived.
But hey, they blew up a capital ship, that's one more I don't have to face. Works for me.
Our backup is joining the fight.
Trade routes are starting to
Allied forces are being attacked.
Ooh, good target practice, boys.
Weapons ready.
Research complete.
Fighters already blowing up skip rays.
Yes, Commander.
Gladiators are coming.
Scanning targets.
This will make this much quicker.
Frigate standing by for orders.
I can watch the pretties a little bit, since I'm mainly trying not to do that with this video. And I need a little bit more money for doing anything terribly interesting.
Structure complete.
Sure, we'll get the damage power converter's ability for our Carracks, which will reduce the armor of enemy ships with frigates, or antimatter. And I think it does a little damage.
Research
no,
complete.
It reduces armor and drains in antimatter a little bit, I think. Basically, makes frigates easier to kill, and antimatter using ships will be inconvenienced. Which is what light frigates do. The Golan over there. Oh, hey, there's our Star Galleons, bringing the commerce of the many Imperial worlds together. Oh, I should probably build a trade port here, too. Another fun fact. Having trade ships in planet that the pirates attack tends to confuse them. About half of them will go attack the trade ships, which makes it much easier for your defenses or a handful of ships, maybe even a single capital ship to deal with. That's always nice.
Research complete.
Frequency open.
Oh yeah, I forgot. The radiation storm here really reduces your antimatter regeneration 250%.
Planet development finished.
So it makes it really, really slow to capture these metal extractors. In fact, I might upgrade some of my antimatter generation, though I suspect it won't make a huge difference compared to that. It's time to fleet up again.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Station ready. Station ready.
Ready for battle.
Station ready.
Building up my defenses. Make sure they have TIE squadrons is always nice.
Planet development finished.
Got line of sight of
research complete.
Sorry, ships. Oh, I have an ally scout there. Our urban planet is very, very slowly
structure complete.
Increasing in population and prominence.
Research complete.
Despite the sickness. Actually, I'm just going to call this
planet
terrorist.
Development.
That's a plague. It's urban. Yeah. Of course, I just condemned the rat ghouls on myself, but whatever.
Allied backup has arrived. Research complete.
I copy.
Structure complete.
Keep building
research
embassies
complete.
In my allies' territory. Go grab extortion experts to help my ally collect more taxes. Oh, I can grab Terran Rogris, my first hero unit. Fun tip.
Orbital command available.
I'd recommend turning autocast on your hero summoning abilities off. If you didn't know, you get your hero units by researching them in the diplomacy tree. And each, you'll have a special structure at your home world.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Unless you get them. But a lot of people don't seem to realize that you can actually summon them to any planet you own. If you leave the autocast on, they'll show up at your home world as soon as possible. But if I wait a little bit, Let's just research this research away. Complete.
Allied backup has arrived.
You're not terribly important. You're gonna get another naval research station. Start getting my Titan techs.
Research complete. Structure complete.
Awaiting your orders.
And I got Terran Orbital Command research. Available. This ability is now active. You can actually point and click to any planet. I'm going to have them join my main fleet.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
And planet I have my finished. Hero will jump into that planet shortly.
Allied backup has arrived.
And there we go. Terran Rogris, of course, commands an Interdictor 418 cruiser. He is supposed to be an earlier version of Admiral Rogris.
Research
who showed
complete.
Up in some of the X-Wing novels.
Research complete.
Right
he was
away.
One of the only guys I could find who named characters who used an Interdictor, so that is why he's in the mod this way.
On my way, sir. Right away. Proceeding to target.
Naturally, as an Interdictor, he automatically has the ability to power his gravity well projectors and keep any ships that are in range from jumping to hyperspace until he runs out of antimatter or takes too much damage. He also has the ability to move while using his gravity well projectors, which not all Interdictor
Structure
units
complete.
Have. And of course, you can get him without needing the five
Allied
military labs to get an
attacked.
Actual immobilizer. Well, this is an actual immobilizer, but you know. Build ones that aren't heroes.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
And we'll give him Imperial Honor so that he can heal my ships.
Your orders?
And I believe I got Commander just now, so yes, I can build the fearsome Imperial
Allied
Star
backup
Destroyer.
Has arrived.
Yes. The first of the big boys. The large 1,600 meter Star Destroyers that you're able to produce
a friendly
with the Commander.
Arrived.
We get the rest of them over at Captain.
Research complete.
Oh wow, I have a lot of money now. I should probably keep building stuff. More gladiators and some lasers.
Backup has arrived.
A little bit of everything, actually. Ooh. Forgot with Imperial ships you can't be too quick heavy. I'm down to 32 already. But that's alright. Kinda want
a friendly fleet has arrived.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna start exploring things, because I'm a little disappointed I didn't get a industrial planet
Star
on this
Destroyer
map.
Reporting
I'm
in.
Going to relocate my ship production facilities.
Allied backup has arrived.
Your 5% bonus is really nice to guarantee you have one planet as the Empire that will give you a ship discount, but
analysts have found something interesting.
Subsurface crystal deposits. Yeah, that's pretty minor. 10% crystal bonus. Meh.
Nothing of value has been found.
Get more population.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Grab that hospital.
Nothing of value has been found. Nothing of value has been found.
Wait. Why are you guys going
Order
that way?
Confirmed.
Oh, no.
We're moving out. Preparing for hyperspace jump.
One thing to be aware
I
of.
I copy. Reporting.
When you're putting, that's
Full
good.
Speed.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
If I want to take that way, I suppose I can.
Phase jump complete.
Yay, we got two of the metal extractors. After who knows how long.
Research complete.
Gonna grab the governor's suit tech so that in
Ready
case
to commence.
I'm not actually facing any enemies with super weapons that do damage, but at least to my planets. But always good to have the ability to build star bases that can make your planets immune from being captured by force.
Allied backup has arrived.
or bombing damage, super weapon damage. Basically, you can only lose them if you have a cultural revolution, which the rebels might actually be better at, but... Oh... You're pretty far out of the way, so you're just gonna be my research base. Bessemer.
Research complete.
The dwarf planet on the edge of the solar system. Oh yeah, I should probably get fighters and these gladiators.
Star Destroyer standing by.
On the beach on the Star Destroyer, and I like to get the deploy gunboats as the first ability. But I might be biased because they're my favorite starfighter in Star Wars. The Alpha Class gunboats, also sometimes called. The full name is Alpha Class XG-1 Star Wing Gunboats from the TIE Fighter X-Wing series.
Has arrived.
Which is quite a mouthful, but they're fun.
Research complete.
I didn't find that much. So I'll keep going on my exploration, hoping to find a planet bonus that'll reduce my ship costs. So I can... Basically, that's just gonna determine where...
Structure complete.
I build my...
Research complete.
I'm gonna make... If I don't find anything, I'll just use my homeworld to produce my fleet.
Officers and crew are ready for action. Ready for action, Commander.
If I do find something,
we're
I'd like
to
move it elsewhere.
Coordinates.
Because your homeworld Terran planets
found.
Have really good social specialization to get really high planet
fleet
population,
arrived.
Which means ridiculous taxes as the Empire, but... It reduces your ship build time, so you don't want to do that.
Allied backup has arrived.
On the planet you're using to produce your fleet.
Nothing of value has been found.
Hey, we found an artifact.
Allied forces
separation
are being
plant.
Attacked.
That'll give me extra resource income. Never
Research
bad thing.
Complete. Analysts have found something interesting.
Cobalt deposit.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Awaiting your command.
You know what? I have so much credits. I'm just going to purchase some levels for my Star Destroyer. It's especially good for the Empire to do that, since they are rather capital ship. Well, I'll talk to that more late game, but... They have very good capital ships, and they have a lot of credit income potential. So, therefore, why not purchase some capital ship levels? Make your strong points even stronger.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Strike cruisers seems like a good idea.
Intel reports an impending pirate raid.
Well, at least they're kind of looking at attacking my ally this time.
I copy.
I mean, it's not...
Yes, sir.
Great news, but at least it won't be me.
Attacking an empire has become more profitable.
They really want to hit me, it looks like. Seen up. We got a little bounty in the pot. We're up to guarded, which means they will send siege frigates this time.
Allied backup has arrived.
I don't remember the exact ships each raid's level sends, but.
Shuttle standing by.
A friendly fleet has arrived. Research complete. Pirate raiders are on the loose. Our backup is joining the fight.
I guess we'll finish. Well, you already have an artifact.
Allied forces are being attacked.
I typically explore my planets until I find an artifact, since that's the main thing you're looking for.
Allied backup has arrived. A friendly fleet has arrived.
I guess sort of getting to that point where I have more money than what I know what to do with. I'll go back and get some other stuff.
Planet
Start
development
the build-up
finished.
Period of the game here, since it looks like my ally is keeping the rebels busy and the Vasari just got a really bad starting
Ready
position.
Ready for action!
May as well send
right
my
away.
Little corvettes.
Go On our way!
Off.
Research
See what
complete.
The rebels are building across
Unit
the border.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
Nothing of value has been found. Nothing of value has been found. Nothing of value has been found.
And we found another three artifacts. Hope if I remember which tab to look at. Ooh. Sparty cloning
Allied
cylinder.
Allied backup has arrived.
Which will nicely give us...
Phase jump complete.
Extra fleet supply and better shields.
Nothing of value
always
has
a good
been
thing.
Found.
There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, they are attacking me. Oh, fun.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Oh, I should have built some defenses here, since the pirates seem like they're going to like to attack this. Maybe the trade ships will distract them.
Ready for orders, sir.
Oh, screw it, I'll just build more ships. It'll be faster for me to actually...
Research complete.
...do that, then. Send my fleet back there, and I'm going to build a detector. Which I just unlocked since I'm now at captain rank. It's basically an Imperial
Allied
Star Destroyer without a hangar bay,
Allied
but more heavily armored.
Are being attacked.
I would definitely recommend one in every Imperial fleet. Because it can increase the armor of your entire fleet, so... Most people like their ships not to die as quickly.
Reporting. Weapons ready.
Guys.
Yes, sir.
Probably not the best thing to send the gladiators into combat first, but whatever. Because we can up their armor a little bit.
Ready to commence.
And I can max out my Terran planet upgrades, which also includes urban.
Our fleet is under attack.
I think that's the only planet type on the map, actually, because we don't have any industrial or agricultural planets on
Reporting.
This random map.
Allied backup has arrived.
I do recommend
Ready for duty.
Durasteel Curtain. That's the ability that the detector has to buff the armor of allied ships.
Adjusting course.
Station ready.
Well, I got a repair bay up. That'll help the gladiators survive a little bit.
Inputting coordinates. I copy.
You guys on fire? Fun fact, if you're trying to build ships in the middle of the siege and your constructors are taking fire, not a bad idea to manually cast the repair ability on it, just to make sure it'll finish its goal in 3. Doesn't look like you're gonna blow it up, but better safe than sorry.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Oh,
research complete. Research complete. Structure complete.
No hangar. Still pretty.
Station ready.
And the golem platform's online.
Allied backup.
Did I research the missiles for it? Yes, I did. So I fully upgraded golems. This is a perfect situation for it. Nice and close. And fully upgraded. Can fire in all the directions. Well, almost all the directions that it can. Rebels really have not built up any defenses on this oceanic planet at all. I could probably go crush them now if I wanted to. What fun is that? Do I have any starbase constructors? Nope. Got a few. Still have not found any planet bonuses that reduce ship costs, so I might just
arrived.
Be stuck with using my homeworld.
A friendly
I guess
fleet
in theory, this urban planet will make up the income that I would have been getting eventually.
Research complete.
Ooh.
Reporting.
Both the rebels and my ally have got some of their heroes up. Their first two, it looks
Planet
like.
Planet development finished.
Gonna go for a bit of a battle.
Research complete.
There's General Iblis for the rebels and Traced Crefay.
Frigate standing by for
we'll
orders.
Talk about them when I eventually do the rebel version of this series next. Guess I can't hurt to grab shield generators. Oh, we got another artifact.
nothing of value has been found.
Synergy. Ooh, efficient bureaucracy. Always nice, that will reduce the costs of most ships and structures. So, I didn't get a bonus that reduces ship cost, but I got an artifact, which is actually even better. And of course, fits the Empire. Of course, our...
This deal's good for both of us, don't you think?
Giant, galaxy-spanning organization isn't
nothing of corrupt. Value found.
We can build Triangle Ships of Dune very, very efficiently, thanks to Kuwait.
Awaiting instructions.
Is my culture being pushed back? Nope. Okay, so Vasari are definitely very slowly moving there. They just had no good way to expand. It happens sometimes, guys.
Ready for command.
And the Tector knocked up.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Ooh, leveled up to level 3, actually. So that was a really good experience. I don't have to pay for the cost. So I'm gonna get... The next ability I really like on it is Energy Surge. If you know the Power Surge ability on the Kortal, it's kind of similar. Helps it regenerate its shields. Makes a very tough ship to destroy.
Adjusting course. Location confirmed.
Should probably go capture the Star Forge over here. These are... I call them ancient structures. They're very powerful super weapons. Or other sort of alien technology. But you need to find artifacts on your planets to... Ooh. The rebels are there. And they've built an they're building an experimental weapon. The rebel super weapon spawns in ships to start rebellions at your planet. So I'm going to have to fortify all my planets now. I'll just go with a Golan and two repair platforms for now. Unless they can hit any one of my planets with it. That's kind of annoying, but... That's life.
Inputting coordinates.
I, of course, get the galaxy gun, which is, in fact, much worse, so... Well, for the people living on the planet. The rebel super weapon can, of course, be used to help their military advances by spawning in temporary reinforcements.
Station ready.
Galaxy gun cannot do that.
Has arrived.
You guys should already be set. And now Imperial rule has been cemented with orbital facilities above all civilized systems. Most excellent.
I copy.
I could actually go
right away.
I might actually go do that. Try and nip them in the bud with that insurrection center they're going to try and pull.
Our backup is joining
the fight. Did I put strike cruisers? Strike cruisers are actually really, really important. For the Empire
Allied
strategy.
Forces are being attacked.
How many? Five capital ships. Wow, that's more than I thought.
An Allied capital ship has been destroyed.
And looks like my ally is actually winning the fight, but they lost the capital ship. Still see all the quite a few of the rebels.
Structure complete.
So. Are being quite relentless, though.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Cruiser online.
Rebels would probably wish they just built more ships at the end of this, but...
Allied backup has arrived.
Did I explore all my core planets?
An Allied capital ship has been destroyed.
Not quite. Lost two capital ships? Ouch.
Cruiser online.
They lose Iblis?
Structure complete. Structure complete.
Like
friendly fleet has arrived.
We get some basic packs up. Oh, and I can get Grand Admiral Thrawn.
Allied backup has arrived.
Orbital command available.
Oh, certain sections. Oh boy. So they fired their insurrection center.
Nothing of value has been found. Allied forces are being attacked.
Should see rebel ships. Oh, they used it on the pirate base. That's not a good target. It really isn't. The AI does love to attack it with super weapons, though. That's some of the ships they get, some dreadnoughts, some marauder cruisers. Fun stuff.
Structure complete.
Yeah, still have a lot of money. Structure complete. Ooh, I can finally upgrade the population there.
Research complete.
Naval research here.
Ready for duty.
Ah, yes. What was that? Strike cruisers.
Research complete.
Oh, and if star base constructors, I should probably build.
Sir?
Anyway, strike cruisers.
Awaiting orders.
Structure complete.
They are the Empire's
cruiser standing by.
Support cruiser.
Structure complete.
They also, among other things, they have this upgrade system you can use to pay extra money to make them better. But the main reason you want them is for their research availability covering
planet
fire.
Planet development finished.
This will reduce the damage this friendly target takes by 50%.
Cruiser online.
The Empire does not have a repairer for you.
Yes, Commander.
This is intentional because basically the smaller ships, the Empire's frigates and cruisers, they're actually pretty good stat-wise, but
research complete.
They have almost no support for them. No cheap robotics cruisers to help keep your fleet up to date, and repaired, nothing. They just are viewed as expendable. You're going to have this massive credit-based economy after all. You are the Empire. You can afford to not care that much about the little guys, and instead focus on the Star Destroyers. And the Strike Cruisers are very good at that, because repair basically acts
structure
as,
complete.
If you're being healed for 20 hull points per second, you're basically, in combat, you're basically negating 20 points worth of damage per second if you're taking more than that. With a percentage reduction of 50%, that's a pretty large amount, and it's gonna
your order, sir?
Be better the more damage it's taking.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
So it's very good for keeping your very powerful and useful capital ships alive, which is what the Empire really cares about.
Our ally has completed construction of a Titan.
They finished a Titan. Well, now I have to
research
do that
research complete.
Kind of surprised the Rebels didn't get there first, but their loss. Can I build one here? Since I only found one planet with a ship cost reduction, naturally it's going to work. It's not much.
This deal's good for both of us, don't you think?
Oh, do we start doing packs? Awesome.
Intel reports an impending pirate raid. Allied backup has arrived.
Build some more fighters. Get some more slots.
Research complete. Attacking an empire has become more profitable. Allied forces are being attacked. A friendly fleet has arrived. Allied backup has arrived.
Oh, since I haven't really been attacked, this hasn't come up, but I've neglected to mention the Empire's main weakness this whole game. That is the morale system. Basically, the Empire is really, really, really good, as long as
pirate
they don't lose planets.
On the loose.
If you do lose planets,
reporting.
Planet development finished.
All of your worlds will take a hit to ship production time, tax income, and culture spread rate, and your ships will do less damage and take more damage. And for the ships, it stacks.
Structure
so if you lose
complete.
Three planets in short succession, your fleet is going to be at only a fraction of its normal effectiveness. Well, maybe not quite that severe, but you're going to feel it. So the Empire kind of rewards a very steady expand, secure, fortify, expand. Basically, you need to make sure your planets are properly defended, that little rebels won't slip between your lines and liberate unsuspecting worlds. Your whole civilization is based on security.
Awaiting your orders.
So if you can't protect your planets, not even these little asteroids and dwarf planets, then what good is the people giving up their freedoms to your rule? So, fortunately...
Order acknowledged.
It doesn't look like we have a big risk of that. Complete. And I'm still building up my front line here, just to be safe.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Where can I throw another military lab? I think I need Rear Admiral. That's the next one. Naturally, I want to get an executor to be my jump. Titan. Of course, the Empire actually has quite a few choices in Titan that I'll mention later, but the executor is the most more powerful one. And as the Empire, you can also get Darth Vader, which is naturally much preferred thanks to
fleet has arrived.
Force powers. Oh, that's interesting. I believe they just used their super weapon on my front line there, just as I jumped to destroy it.
Attack.
Well, that'll be interesting.
Officers and crew are ready for action.
Right away. Crews are online. Crews are standing by. Targeting.
Yeah, my strike crew is already trying to, use covering fire on. They can also use it on star bases or really any target, but they do prefer
structure
large
complete.
Targets like Titan star bases
a
and capital ships.
Arrived.
That's what it's intended for. So that'll help me tank the damage. Really need another repair bay.
Station ready.
Yeah, go take out that carrier. We don't want it bombing our planet. I disapprove of that. Waiting on Rear Admiral. As well start pumping out some Vindicators, your proper heavy cruiser.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
Damage dealer, and it has an ability that helps it escort your capital ships better. Yep, there's that insurrection center.
Structure complete.
We will not use this planet to encourage my people to rebel against me any longer. The Iron Fist of the Empire blows on you. There's no way out. There's not even anything really defending this planet. No chance. The refinery ships are gone. My TIE fighters and weapons. Everything in sight.
Awaiting your command.
Tell to flat up blow
ready
up
to go
as quick as possible. Ooh, dual fates. Always nice. Defenders of the Empire. Yes, I need propaganda to boost my defenders.
A friendly
and again, slightly
arrived.
Reduce my costs in recruiting. Get some ship build. Also worth noting that the Empire has a few unique techs the Warlords have that deal with the Force, since Darth Vader leads your faction. Foresight to see all enemy culture on the map. Inquisitoris to hunt down dissidents and other Force users, increasing your culture resistance. And most importantly, Battle Meditation, which will improve the sheer ship's combat in your culture. All very worthwhile, of course.
Station ready.
And time to upgrade the starbase.
Crews are standing by. Moving out.
Research complete.
Yes, sir. Your order, sir. Crews are online.
Get out of there.
Station ready.
But the insurrection is being mopped up thanks to the timely construction of my starbase.
Station ready.
The unit isn't upgraded. Along with the TIE fighters from my Golem platform, we're more than sufficient.
Our planet
to deal with them, Insurrection Center is gone, and it's being bombarded. Kron is being pacified, I mean. Peace will return to this sector. No civilians died. I don't know what you're talking about. Turbo laser bombardment is very accurate and safe. Ignore those very large explosions. Only rebels are being killed.
We have wiped out an enemy colony.
And it is now mine. I guess I can use it to do my final research labs.
Research complete.
And I should be able to build my Titan now.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
You actually have three options. The first is the Bellator Star Dreadnought. This is sort of a vanilla balanced Titan. It's relatively fast, and it's designed as a capital ship hunter, but it doesn't do as well in fleet engagements, but it has some good things to counter capital ship and buff your fleet
planet
a bit.
Development finished.
You can have just a normal executor
research complete
class dreadnought. It's basically a very tough battle platform. Since there are no suicidal A-wings in the mod, quite difficult to get rid of. And let's see. Very good single target firepower as well, with its abilities, particularly its ultimate ability. But you're playing as the Galactic Empire, which means you really have to get Darth Vader, who also has an executor, but he can force choke the enemy.
Don't you think? Research complete.
And the rebel fleet is gathering at this wormhole.
Right away.
Oh, actually, moving out. Let's see if they come to me. I should fortify this planet before I go, actually.
Another structure is in the way.
I don't want those rebels to retake this world.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Logistics. Explore.
Yes, Commander.
We'll get
full speed.
A friendly fleet
It'll
has
be
arrived.
A little while, although I did grab the shipbuilding expert tech, which will increase the shipbuilding rate of all planets that
Research
have
complete.
A capital ship or Titan factory. Get some more abilities.
Allied backup has arrived.
Probably do that. Oh, actually, I'm going to get the Imperial Academy.
Planet development finished.
The Empire is the only faction that gets an extra level of the research that lets you train capital ships more. This means they can actually train
Structure
their capital
complete.
Ships up to level 5 with credits.
A friendly fleet
oh,
arrived.
Are they using the wormhole?
Nothing of value has been found.
Doesn't look like it. Where did their fleet go?
Awaiting your orders.
They attack me? Where are they going? Just a bunch of MC-40A light cruisers. Looks like my ally has used their Titan
Allied
to smash the
arrived.
Enemy front line.
Research complete.
Zob has fallen. They will advance on a Duba 3, home of the Yavin defenders. Even though I believe Yavin is... No. I thought I saw Yavin 4. It happened to be the random
Nothing
name
of value
one of these
has
planets.
Been found.
Oh, well. Ooh. Ooh. Looks like they finally took the desert planet there.
Structure complete.
I'm gonna need some more culture over here.
Allied backup has arrived. A friendly fleet has arrived.
Actually, this social does increase my population growth rate. Heck yes. I need that on this urban planet. I could also. The Empire also has really good culture suppression with its capital
yes,
ships,
Commander.
Since that was one of their main roles to spread
Allied
fear and terror. I mean, security and prosperity to the Imperial planets. So they are very good at repelling enemy culture.
Reporting in.
Some Vindicators.
Planet development.
Should probably
finished.
Get another strike cruiser. Some more gladiators.
Structure complete.
Where are we? Obviously, executors take quite a long time to build, and almost, man, oh wow, with all my techs, I've actually severely lowered the cost. Only about 13,000 credits, that's really good. With the 5% bonus here, the artifact I found. Reporting. Another 15% off.
Crews are online.
A friendly fleet arrived. Actually, the credit
costs. Yeah. 2% there. It all adds
structure
up.
Structure complete.
Ooh.
Allied forces are being attacked.
I want a galaxy gun,
attacked.
Why not? Some Vindicators, some Gladiators, a strike cruiser to join my...
Research complete.
Darth Vader.
Reporting.
When he's done. Could be another capital ship. May as well get Imperial too. Oh, actually. Stop what I'm doing, I have 8 military labs. You may notice this is the only tier 8 research the Empire gets in the military tree.
Frigate standing by for orders.
Thankfully, that's my ally building an Ovalith cannon, so I don't care about that alarm.
Reporting.
Allied backup has arrived.
Oh. I should probably...
Station ready.
Yeah, we want the governor's suite. Just
frigate
sure
standing by for orders.
There or there. A hostile empire has launched a Titan. Good. We'll get one fleet
station ready.
This game.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Not that I expect them to be any match for the might of Lord Vader.
Star Destroyer reporting in.
Is almost done constructing.
Your command,
Imperial
sir.
2, the Whirlwind.
Yeah, allied backup has arrived.
Research. Get all 5. The upgrades. Training, I should say.
Additional research required.
Kron has been secured.
An allied capital ship
out of place
structures,
that would be most annoying.
Join me, and together we can rule the galaxy.
Guess who got done?
Don't underestimate the force.
I will not.
Ready to commence.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Naturally, as the only force user currently in the mod, Vader is quite special. I recommend. I guess I'll just go over them. Do Not Fail Me, of course, is your fleet buff, and or fleet support buff, and it will motivate your
nothing
commanders to
structure complete.
Perform better,
research
increasing
complete.
Energy weapon cooldown and shield restore rate. Of course, with the excellent promotion
don't
opportunities Lord Vader gives his minions, not the threat of sudden death for failure. Flagship is a passive for every capital ship near Lord Vader, the Executor will get, I should probably
allied
rename him,
has
it's
arrived.
Actually be the Executor, cursed sins, random names. There we go.
A friendly
it will reduce the
arrived.
Damage the Executor takes, while increasing the damage of all the capital ships that are around him, so basically, capital ships near Lord Vader increase damage, Lord Vader takes less damage. Then, of course, Force Choke, which will... I didn't get ship upgrades. Well, we'll talk about them later.
Nothing
different video,
of
perhaps.
Has been found.
Will disable
allied
the
backup
abilities
arrived.
Of any ship you use it on, including Titans, and it will reduce the damage and antimatter of the target. So very good for crippling a single powerful target. But we'll go at Do Not Fail Me and Force Choke for the first level.
Yeah.
And it's time to smash the rebellion, I think. Oh, and for funds.
Allied forces are being attacked.
We got a galaxy gun back here, safe in the back. I might fortify that.
Allied backup has arrived.
This is pretty.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Well secured. I did not upgrade the population on this all the way. Another galaxy gun there, just to help speed this game up so I don't have to waste so much time bombing stuff. Oh yeah, I never actually got
planet
my siege
development finished.
The Acclimator. I should build some of those. I want to be Admiral. Admiral Goa.
This deal's good for both of us, don't you think?
I guess my ally is handling the pack situation.
A friendly
Rust
fleet
armor.
Has arrived.
I'm okay with this. My allies.
That's it.
How'd the rebels take that back?
Pirate raiders are on the loose.
The Titans go. They both the Titans. You have a Liberty. Good capital ship.
Phase jump complete.
Where the? Oh. They put the. They retreated their Ragnarok and the rebels made a counterattack, it looks like. Ooh.
Research
hero
complete.
Kerfaze leading this fleet. I don't see a Titan. I think I'm gonna get another starbase constructor to fortify my gas giant, just because the Vasari have been rather quiet lately.
Allied backup has arrived.
It's never a good thing.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
I'm gonna put a shield generator on it too, just because of how weak its health is.
Your orders? We're on our way.
We can't rout these rebels.
An allied capital ship has been destroyed.
Destination is acknowledged.
Don't be too proud of this technological terror you've constructed.
The Battle of the Wormhole.
Planet development finished.
Armed and ready.
Oh, go chase them.
Locking on.
Looks like they're just gonna run, but they're rebels.
Starting attack position.
Kerfay is actually being rather bold.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Let's make him pay for that error.
Structure complete. Research complete. Structure complete.
Gladiators throwing out squirt missiles. Let's die. Not gonna be able to take Kerfay out before he jumps, though. Oh, do I have
a friendly fleet?
Nope. You activated my Terran Rock Reese's gravity well generators. He can no longer jump. Of course, he loses antimatter at a constant rate. But, as you can see, the duration is not an issue here. And I hit them again to turn them off, so I can start regaining my antimatter again. One free hero kill I wouldn't have otherwise gotten.
Structure complete.
Oh, this planet has toxic fallout.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Well. No wonder they were using it as an insurrection center, probably to train rebel commandos in its harsh environment.
Allied backup has arrived.
Could use a few more civic labs. Administration, I should say.
Don't be too proud of this technological terror you've constructed.
Actually, you know what, guys? Just go and attack. They're front line. If you really need the help, my guys will be over here at the wormhole while we pick off rebel ships. The only capital ship I don't have is Interregnum Star Destroyer. I don't know why I haven't done the research for that. You do need to research the Mobilizer 418 before you can get the Interregnum Star Destroyer, which is basically... Oh, the pirates are trying to attack me again.
Planet development finished.
I don't anticipate that well for them. It'll be free training for my interdictor too, so good stuff.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Of course, I gotta get the starbase constructor all the way over here, but I think it has enough health to survive the pirates. Of course, star dreadnoughts are not fast. Certainly not the Executor. It's taking a while. Oh yeah, I was gonna build some siege frigates as well. Acclimators. The acclimator is kind of unique in that. For a siege frigate, it's actually has acceptable combat stats,
structure
much more
complete.
Durable, and does much more
structure
firepower
complete.
Than the vanilla siege frigates, but they're also a bit more expensive. Actually, substantially more expensive. You get what you pay for again, but if you just want something to bomb planets, they're not strictly
allied
the best at that
arrived.
Job, and I see some people, you're building
research
a lot of
complete.
Fleets with them. I mean, they look really cool. They're from the movies, and they can do that, but honestly, they're not your best combat
ready,
ships.
Ready, sir.
They just sort of can carry the fleet
Allied
supply you're investing in them
attacked.
In a fight as well, if you're
what
taking
are your orders?
A contested planet.
Navigating.
But they do have the fairly weak armor that most siege frigates have, so a lot of health, but it'll take a lot of damage.
Allied backup
but they
has
are
arrived.
Yeah, get over there. Oh yeah, I should probably get Thrawn out.
Orbital command available.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
Phase jump complete.
I don't have enough crystal. Wow. I've been doing a lot of research, I suppose.
Do you have something to report?
Allied backup has arrived.
Level 5 before the action begins.
Our planet is under siege.
Oh, I should probably get TIE interceptors, shouldn't I? So much stuff. One note about advanced fighters. In the Empire's case, interceptors,
preparing
defenders,
for hyperspace
although that's
jump.
Mainly for the warlords.
Research complete.
And assault gunboats on Dark Vader. They do cost antimatter to build on the few units that can field them. Mainly your later capital ships, Titans, star bases, heroes. So, all these units have to use antimatter for their abilities as well. So,
Allied backup
if you're losing a lot of fighters, they're going to be competing with antimatter for your abilities, and they might cause you to run out of antimatter and not being able to use your special abilities before they might otherwise have. So, do be a little bit careful and not just, you know, throw only TIE interceptors on a Star Destroyer just because they're better. Oh, check. Speaking of advanced fighters, they have A-Wings against my Executor. No! Unfortunately, I don't think they'll live very long.
Allied forces
my Lancers
are being attacked.
And TIE fighters.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Making swift work. The Dodonna Mon Calamari Command Cruiser is being force choked by Lord Vader. It's wisely deciding to run. Yeah, there's not a lot here.
Thrawn reporting.
Resist me at this point. Oh yeah, we never got the strike cruisers.
Cruiser standing by.
Should fix that.
Yes, Commander.
Ready for orders. Bombers at the ready.
My super weapons, I guess, are firing at random. I don't really care enough to direct them at this point,
Allied
so
backup
that's
has
fine.
Arrived.
This deal's good for both of us, don't you think?
Siege packs. That could be useful. Thank you, Mr. Ally.
I copy. On the way.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
The system has been cleared, it looks like.
Allied backup has arrived. Our backup is joining the fight.
Going on to High Admiral. Just so I can get my last hero unit.
More crystal is needed.
Yes, Commander.
Ooh, they have a starbase there. Maybe I should get some broadside cruisers, too.
Allied backup has arrived.
You know what, I'll probably just build some shipyards here. Regardless of what bonuses it has, just because I don't want something
planet
on the front lines. It's
finished.
Too long having to wait for my siege frigates to come all the way over here.
Reporting.
Oh, yeah.
Ready for your orders, sir.
This is the Interdictor Star Destroyer. Again, just very, very large Interdictor cruiser that can actually fight for its own in combat somewhat. Actually has the gravity well generators that
has arrived.
The earlier ones do, but they have some other fun gravity manipulation stuff.
An allied
that's actually one of its abilities, which lets allied ships jump faster towards the gravity well, the interdictor's at. It's a passive. Well, it slows down enemy ships, so lets you get reinforcements faster and slows down enemy forces. But gravitational waves is probably my favorite.
A friendly fleet arrived.
Got some TIE interceptors, why not?
Reporting.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Reduce all physical damage, autocannons, missiles, proton torpedoes by 75%. Every faction but the Advent have at least one physical weapon in it. For all of them but them, it includes their hard-hitting bombers and long-range frigates.
Standing by.
So it's a very useful defensive ability to have, and it totally owns the TDC, since they are very reliant on those type of abilities. Those type of weapons, I should say. Rebels are trying to mount a counterattack.
Awaiting your orders.
Yes, and yes, I'll bring the fleet together.
We've wiped out an enemy colony.
What level are you at, Thrawn? One more to go, still? Yep.
Research complete.
Have anything
else? Destroyer here.
We'll buy levels for you
Allied
guys, too.
Allied backup has arrived.
Get all my capital ships
awaiting
at least
orders.
At level 5.
Cruiser reporting.
We made it at 5.
I await
actually.
Your instructions.
Got one more. Now we'll get my last hero, Admiral Piet.
Setting course.
Research complete.
Who is not with Vader on the Executor anymore. He's been given his own command of a very unique ship. Also, there's this nice heroic valor tech every faction gets that basically refunds the fleet costs of using hero units at the end. So,
a friendly fleet has arrived.
Most people like more fleets and more capital ships.
Station ready. Station ready.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Really need more crystal. Though I have the credits, I suppose I can just do this. Buy a crap ton of it off the market.
Allied backup has arrived.
Yes.
Your command, sir.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Get some good points of induced terror. This is a really good ability on the Imperial II that is perhaps even vital to your success late game with the Empire. It basically shuts down the antimatter regeneration of enemy fleets. I mentioned that the Empire doesn't have a good repair ship, but this will shut down the both abilities of enemy capital ships and the support cruisers repair ships of enemies, so they'll have a hard time healing as well.
I await your instructions.
You probably need two to keep it locked
Destroyer
down
here.
All the time, but, you know, even 44 seconds without
weapons ready.
Reporting.
Being able to restore your antimatter means your enemy will run out of abilities quite quickly.
Star Destroyer standing by.
I should mention also the Imperial
Research
One,
complete.
In addition to spamming gunboats, which are more powerful bombers. Has this nice assault shuttle ability,
Allied
which can be
arrived.
Used to capture ships, and of course it also has a tractor beam, which can keep ships from running away, and will increase your the damage your boarding parties do. Sure, TIE interceptors.
Cruiser reporting!
Probably get a lot more miscellaneous research too. I'll max out antimatter and shields, because I can.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
We colonize this. I think if
gunship reporting.
Colonize this.
We're on our way.
Bomber standing by.
You know what? I'm just gonna take out the pirate base.
Bombers at the ready.
Station ready.
Galaxy guns come up.
Station ready.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Station ready.
The Visaria finally taking out that minor faction that spawned right next to them. Another Visari faction. Took them long enough. We now have Thrustra.
Intel reports Plus an drop. Impending pirate raid.
Need some more factories.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Even though oceanic planets are really good for social specialization, but...
Allied
location,
backup
location,
has
location.
Research complete.
Go skip right.
Armed and ready. On our way.
Advance.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
Can we get Piet?
Orbital command available.
We can get Piet.
Research complete.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
As you might notice, Piet has a larger flagship than
Allied
usual.
Backup has arrived.
Yes, He's Commander.
In fact, an Allegiance class battlecruiser.
Our fleet is under attack.
Basically, something between a capital ship and a Titan.
Structure complete.
Understood.
Very. Piet's strong point is that he's also very hard to kill. His signature ability is this uncanny survivor.
Has arrived.
Which will heal him by 50% of his hull points,
Planet
but it has a very long
finished.
Cooldown. So lets him get out of some very unfortunate situations, such as letting the Millennium Falcon escape in episode 5.
Piet reporting for duty, sir.
Somehow Vader didn't kill him for that.
Ready for your orders.
And as Vader's most loyal
structure complete. A friendly
commander, I suppose,
arrived.
He got his own ship. So we'll train up the levels on him a bit, then smash the rebellion once and for all.
Allied backup has arrived.
At your command.
Reporting.
Some more ships there. Oh, that's my interdictor.
Ready for your orders, sir.
I'm not trying to either. That's annoying.
Planet development finished. A friendly fleet has arrived.
Some broadsides, just so I can smash through the line here. More gladiators and vindicators are some of my favorite, like, game ships.
Nothing
we got one immobilizer, why not, even though we have... Actually, nah, I won't bother. Terran, Rogrus, and the Interdictor Star Destroyer should be more than enough to keep the enemy from escaping. Once I can get them into a decisive engagement. That is one huge advantage the Empire has. If they do win a battle, they have the Interdictors to make sure it's decisive. Although, it doesn't work on jump-immune ships. That works on both vanilla phase jump inhibitors and gravity well projectors.
Ready,
so some ships can escape your gravity well projectors, but it's not many.
Oh. Ready for orders.
Pirates are attacking something. Oh. My front line again.
Allied forces are being attacked. Thrawn
to defend it as well.
Station ready.
Allied
some acclimators for good measure. Yeah, they basically
have a friendly fleet has arrived.
Also gonna go ahead and grab this call for reinforcements ability for your star bases. Does exactly what you think. Spawns a temporary defensive fleet to help. So that'll actually be really useful over here if the Visari ever attack this flank. Ooh. Allies attacking the Visari now. Before they've cleared this planet even entirely. I'm sure they won't be too happy about that, but.
A friendly
I'm okay with
fleet
it.
Has arrived.
Might build a shipyard here too, just for the heck of it. Wish they might actually have better industrial specialization. Not surprising, it is a toxic planet after all. Yeah. So go full industrial there. Maybe
Allied
build some forces on
arrived.
That flank. Bronze on these pirates. Oh yeah, what did my scout reveal?
Research complete.
This asteroid has a star base.
Broadside cruiser reporting.
That dwarf planet does not.
A friendly
I think
fleet
we're gonna
arrived.
Go smash it with my combined fleet.
Standing by.
Piet could be a little bit higher level, but.
Planet development finished. Allied backup has arrived.
Yes, Commander.
Well, one thing about detectors I somehow forgot to mention. Rather than an ultimate ability, they have a free passive armored reactors, which prevents them from being disabled, so ion bolt, anything that'll disable weapons, engines, any annoying things like that won't affect detector. They're immune to all that. So another
preparing
nice little
bonus for hyperspace jump. Yes, Commander.
Our fleet is under attack.
We're on our way.
Seems to be a... Ooh. Look at attack me. Oh, you are in the very wrong position, Rebel Fleet.
Research completed.
You picked a very bad day to amass at my border. This is the day that we'll crush you.
Research completed.
Broadside cruiser reporting.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Yeah, they're so outnumbered, that's not good. Oh, and the Imperial March is playing. How fitting.
Reporting.
Gonna get Terran Rog Grease actually in position.
Awaiting orders.
Shut down enemy escape route.
Awaiting your orders.
Just gonna put them over here.
Proceeding to target.
Not even any enemies on the other side to grab you up. Rebels were trying to destroy my acclimators while they're to defend the planet, but that's gonna be gone before then. We're gonna lose control of the planet before I can even take out my shields.
Enemy colony.
Yes, Commander. Awaiting your orders.
Research completed.
Blowing up some Mon Calamari.
Ready to die.
Ordinary civility. The tank of the Rebel fleet, but it's alone. It's outmatched. It's gone. Grombal Idris is mounting frantic. Final attack. Looks like I don't actually need my interdictor.
Awaiting
there.
Your orders.
I guess I didn't train you, did I?
Weapons online.
Oh,
your
yeah,
command, sir.
You don't need to hide anymore.
Bomber squadron reporting.
Send my
bomber standing
doxy
by.
Guns to
ready for orders.
Take out the pirates, just because I don't really want to do it. It's better just to nuke them into oblivion, though they do have a shield generator, so they only take 50% damage, so I don't know if this will quite be enough.
Arrived.
Ready to go.
I do have enough planets to build my third galaxy gun, so we're going to go ahead and do that.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Victory, where are you? You should be colonizing this by now, that's why I have you around.
TIE squadron here.
Good work.
Ready for your
Thank
orders,
you,
sir.
Cruiser reporting. Destination confirmed.
Planet development finished.
Good work. I am altering the deal. Pray I don't alter it any further.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
I'm gonna grab some
more crystal is needed.
Battle meditation, and of course I need more crystal. Somehow I've run out of credits. I didn't think I was building that much.
Awaiting orders.
Oh yeah, I have this fleet over here. I
yes, sir.
Added
ready to go.
Probably not really necessary. But
this feels good for both of us, don't you think?
Gladiators. A little defense force on this flank.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
And I have
Planet
all the packs, so
finished.
Now I have even more fleet supply that I'm probably never going to use.
Allied
well, I can
backup
use it,
has arrived.
But... Oh, let's see. build a Star Destroyer over there. I think I'll build a Venator to guard.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Against any Vasari menaces. No, it said we got an enemy Titan. Did my ally take it out? Is Admiral Akbar just waiting to try and throw a trap at me?
A friendly fleet arrived.
When I attack their homeworld?
Allied backup has arrived.
Do you have something to report? I knew you would say that.
Unit preparing for jump to light speed.
Inputting coordinates.
Guess I could sell my metal.
Reporting.
Well, not all of it, but...
Structure complete.
I crashed the market, but that's no surprise.
Planet development finished.
Guess I should grab some of my economic stuff I've been kind of neglecting. Max out my, high
research
population
complete.
Research.
More crystal is needed.
But I can boost my trade a bit
Reporting.
More. Then also I have forced taxation. Which of course gives you more taxes. Did we take them out? We did.
Reporting.
I think my ally must have nuked them with their Novalith cannons, or maybe mine did that.
Bomber standing by.
But they got super weapon to death.
Planet development finished.
Well.
Ready for orders. Bombers at the ready.
That's the Empire for you, I suppose. Resist us, and we'll nuke you from orbit.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Yeah. Well, or my ally did it. We both have inner...
Frigate standing by for orders.
Interplanetary
Preparing
missiles
for hyperspace
that
jump.
Massive amounts of damage to planets, so...
Bomber squadron reporting.
Allied forces are being attacked.
Get off out
of Bomber squadron reporting.
Could get the Galactic Empire is another level of this political prisoners,
attack.
Which lets
nothing of value
gives you
found.
Resources from your metal extractors. So I might grab that to alleviate any credit.
Ready to commence.
Well, it's not really credits. It's a Imperial March again.
Skipway blast boat here.
As we demolish the Rebels' shipbuilding facilities and their last Marauder cruiser defending it. Something interesting. Smuggler's base. Alright, you're getting some trade ports.
Another structure is in the way.
Trade port here already? No, that's the wrong planet, that's why.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Put my trade train a bit longer.
Don't be too proud of this technological terror you've constructed.
Victory.
Standing by. At your command. Navigating to coordinates. Reporting in. Affirmative, sir.
More interceptors.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Rebel capital has been pacified. You can see you have their homeworld bonus letting you know it's their original homeworld, and since I turned on a capital victory
Structure
mode,
complete.
I can't move it.
Structure complete.
The Rebels actually have a research which let them survive the destruction of their homeworld even in capital victory, but clearly
a
they didn't get to research
has
it.
Been founded.
Very short-sighted decision on their part, I think they're regretting.
Ready for orders.
That was Coordinates received. This planet. But I'm pretty sure we can take it out, even if it's fully upgraded. Though I will do local engagement range, just so I can just snipe it from afar if possible. No reason to take unnecessary losses. Also, I mentioned the morale system that if, as the Empire, you lose any planets, you get some nasty debuffs that last quite a while. They do have a tech called Symbolic Victory at the end, though, which basically, if you take out another planet, it'll undo all the morale penalties. So basically, you could say, well, so the Rebels took Kira. Well, we're going to go. We just captured their base at Deveron. We're on the offensive. The Empire has a counterattack ready and undoes some of the negative effects. Of course, if you're generally getting your ass kicked, that's not going to help. But if you're winning on one front and the enemy is winning on another...
Yes, Commander. Commencing attack.
Actually, pretty well defended here. Unfortunately, I jumped right in on the star base, so we're just going to have to zerg it. Or Protoss rush it, since that's technically more what the Empire was like, but, I don't know, I don't actually play StarCraft that much, so my references... Ooh, Vader went up to level 2. Get more weapons and flagship.
Pirate Raiders.
So, wow, he actually has... Oh, he's probably getting the 50% damage reduction from the Strike Cruiser, and then another 42% from his, flagship passive. Yeah, that, Star base is tough, but it's not looking too hot. Fought valiantly. I should mention the Rebel star bases can have an ability to blow themselves up to deal massive damage to all nearby ships. Fortunately, the AI probably didn't get to the round to researching that either, but they do have it. So you do need to be careful attacking Rebel star bases. Capital ship factory's done. Get that Venator. It's my flagship on the this sector of the galaxy. I guess my ally. Oh, I kind of want that cryo planet. I need crystal income.
Awaiting your orders.
Don't underestimate the Force. Don't be
guys?
Too proud of this technological terror you've constructed.
To do local engagement range so they would have charged at the starbase, but of course, that was close enough.
Bombers matter. At the ready. Bombers at the ready.
Galaxy guns, I guess I may as well have
bombers standing by. Bombers
stuff,
at the ready.
Make a friendly reduce fleet the time arrived. I spend bombing things.
Structure complete.
Yeah, we're pretty
Research
much just
complete.
On the mop-up phase here. Since the Vasari got such a slow start, I don't think they're going to be much of a threat, in fact. My allies already at their gates with a rather large fleet. I don't know where the Titan is. I don't really think it matters. Oh, I have another ice
planet
there.
We have wiped out an enemy colony. A friendly fleet has arrived.
You know what? I'm just going to build a... capital ship factory here.
Allied backup has arrived.
So I can build another victory just to colonize this. They're also really good at siege. Basically, the standard victory class does everything but space combat, but they can be very good at occupying and sieging planets. And I don't
Allied
think I've worked a victory too,
attacked.
Did I, this whole game? That's unfortunate. That's actually really useful. So, pulled one over here.
Allied backup has arrived. Planet development finished.
Oh crap.
Don't underestimate the Force.
And the Vasari surrendered.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
The Empire
Structure
is victorious.
Complete. Sorry, but this venture wasn't working out.
I could go fight my ally. Actually, I have a fleet right there. We'll end it there. We'll destroy my ally's fleet
Allied
just to show them who's
arrived.
Top dog, although I don't intend on really finishing this. Since the game's over, alliances auto-terminate, basically. Even though I turned Allied Victory on, and we already won the game.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Gunship reporting.
Oh, I just finished that victory.
Ready for battle. Navigating to coordinates.
Setting course.
Cruiser reporting.
Oh, real quick on the victory 2 before we end. Main abilities are doubled efforts, which is really good for keeping antimatters on your ships up. It adds a little bit of extra antimatter and reduces the cost. Destructive ion bolts is my favorite. It's a passive ability that causes
inputting
the
coordinates.
Ion cannons on the victory 2 to do extra damage to shields.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
And if the shields are breached and the ion cannons hit the ship itself, it will reduce the enemy rate of fire. You can also target communications to debuff all strike craft in the gravity well. And its ultimate ability lets it screen larger capital ships. Better for some extra bonuses to both ships. Oh, right. Pretties. Oh, there's Starbase here too. Three-way battle. Remnants of the Alliance. My former TEC allies that are getting out of control.
Theater reporting for duty, sir.
But all will be smashed by the Empire. At their best, when they can just steamroll everybody. That's really what this faction is about. They struggle a bit more if they have to fight long, protracted battles. But they just have the tools to get more become more powerful than you and get in battles like this where the enemy just doesn't have a chance. And they have the interdictors to make sure it's a decisive victory.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Speaking of which, I should probably
yes, sir.
Put them in position. Where are they likely to retreat to?
Allied
I don't know, they almost seem to be
attacked.
Running for the pirate base? That's not a very good strategy.
Our backup is joining the fight.
Where are you, Captain Rogers?
Reporting.
Ooh, got level 6 on my ISD. Now I can get Imperial Presence, which will increase the shield mitigation of all friendly ships. Again, helping buff the survivability of your entire fleet. Your frigates that don't otherwise have easy access to repair and combat. Really like that.
We have wiped out an enemy colony.
Oh, not actually.
Star Destroyer standing by. Moving to coordinates.
Am I hostile to you or not? No. That's interesting. It said we went.
Allied backup has arrived.
We were at war with each other because we won the game, but I guess it didn't actually do that. That's interesting. They broke all my packs, but I'm not actually at war with them. Oh well.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Oh, that's a bit anticlimactic then. But took out another Rebel starbase. The galaxy is ours. Hopefully this gives you some idea of how to play the Empire. With their strong points, capital ship, tax income.
Allied
don't like losing planets.
Arrived.
Stick to those general rules. You should be fine at them.
Yes.
May not quite be the easiest faction to play because it does punish mistakes, especially on the competitive level, but against the AI, which I think most people play, it's, you know, not that big of a weakness, and it's going to be
preparing
the only Star Wars faction
jump.
Whose
research complete.
Weakness is just the morale system, and it only applies in certain conditions, so, you know, if you're able to go on the offensive and win, you know, keep control the entire game, you have no reason not to play with them.
Allied backup has
so,
arrived.
I guess I'll just
our backup is
leave you
joining
with this
the fight.
Formation of giant triangle ships. And call it a video. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you found it instructive.
Preparing
and thank you for making it this
jump.
Far. I hope to do the other factions. Get a video of their own in the not-too-distant future. And see you all later. Of course.
After
the Imperial alarm go off at the very last second of the video. Bye!